Hello friends, in this video I am showing you how I made this rim from the left in SolidWorks after this picture. Let's start. First you'll have to open a sketch in the right plane. Okay, then you'll have to draw a center line. Actually two. Okay, then we'll have to make the sketch. Then switch to center point arc. Okay, and now let's define this. Here will be 14 millimeters. This will be 8. This from this point to this point will be 9. Okay. This from here to here will be 205. Actually will be 204.95. Okay, this will be 260. Let's make this bigger. Okay, now let's define this one. From here to here will be 41 millimeters. Let's see if this will. Yep, it's working. Let's dimension this. Will be 86.56. Okay, from this point to this line will be 16. Nice. And from this point to this point will be 125. And this is the sketch, the half of sketch for our wheel rim. Now what we have to do is go to feature, go to revolved boss base, select this center line, and we'll have half of the rim. To make the whole rim, we'll go to mirror, here select revolve, here mirror face plane, select this face and press OK, and now we have the whole rim. Okay, now we have to make another plane, so go to reference geometry, plane, here at first reference put front plane. Okay, here put 90 millimeters, and press OK, and we have another plane. Okay, select this plane, open a sketch, normal 2. Okay, and here we're gonna make another sketch. First what we have to do is to make some center lines from here to here, and another one will be here. Let's dimension this other one, will be at 36 degrees. Okay, now let's draw these lines. Just like this. And then let's dimension this. Here will be 200. From from this point to this point will be 100. Okay, here will be 50. And from this point to the center line will be 25. Okay, and from here to this point will be 127.33. Okay, now we have to select point and put a point on this line. Let's give this dimension, will be 190, and then select spline, make it from here to here and until here. Okay, then use mirror, select this spline, mirror about this center line, press OK. Now we have to draw a circle from this point with 15 in diameter, 30, I'm sorry. Okay, now let's put these points on this circle. Okay, let's make a center line from this one to this one, and then make this midpoint. Let's use trim entities and cut this because we don't need it. Okay, and now we can move. Actually, no, we cannot. Oh, I forgot. Okay. Now, what we have to do is to convert this edge into this plane. So, now make sure that all of these points are on this edge. And now we can move this point and modulate this how we want. We have to dimension these points. Here will be 50, and here should be 25. It's not 25, so we'll just delete this. Okay, delete this and put here 25. And put here 25. Okay, and now this should be okay. What we have to do next is to multiply these two sketches around the rim. So for this we're gonna use circular sketch pattern. We have to select all of these lines and put here 5. Press OK and it's almost done. Now with trim entities, we have to cut actually we don't have to do this. We'll just go to feature, extruded boss base, and we have to select this and here put 160. Okay, here switch the direction and press OK. Okay, now hide this plane, and what we have to do next is to cut this extra material. Just go to right plane, make a sketch, normal 2, then go to display style, select this hidden line visible command, and you'll see this to be easier to make the next sketch. Select spline and come from here. And here. Okay, your line should be looking like this. If no, you can model it. Just click on these points and drag them and it will move. Okay, then select line. This should be closer. Just like this. Okay, it's looking good. Okay, select line. From here it doesn't matter the shape or the dimensions. It just have to be bigger than this extra material. And we can also do from here to here. Okay. To cut the extra material and from this side. And now go to features. Revolved cut. And here select this line and press OK. Then go back to display style, select this, and here we have our wheel rim without extra material, just inside. Okay, what we have to do now is to make another sketch. So we'll have to select front plane, sketch, normal 2. Here we have to select polygon with 5 lines from the center. Draw it like this, then go this point and this point, make them vertical. Make this 130. And that's it. What we have to do now is to go to features, extruded boss base, reverse the direction, and here we'll put 50. 50 millimeters, press OK. And now, as you can see, these edges are coming out. So what we have to do is to go back to revolved cut, press here to see the sketch, edit sketch, normal 2, and we'll have to edit this sketch to cover those edges. So I'll just drag from this point and this other one. Okay, let's see now. Are still here, just a little bit more. Okay, exit sketch again. Are still there. Okay. And are gone now. Now select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, here draw a circle, dimension it, the dimension will be 110 millimeters. Okay. Nice, then go to feature, extruded boss base, make here 10 millimeters. Nice, press OK. And now we have to open another sketch on this face. Normal 2, and here we have to draw something what's a little bit complicated, so just follow me. And now we'll just have to define this and make sure that are not moving. Here will be 5, 5. Here will be 47. Okay, now it's only moving the whole sketch. So this is good. What we have to do now is to make it to stay in the center. Okay, now we'll just put, actually no, and just make, I'll just make a center line like this. Make this vertical. And make here, make midpoint. Okay, and define this. Actually, let's do this. Nice. And now go to features, extrude the boss base here. Make it 6 millimeters, press OK, and now we have to make this around the edges. So for this we're just gonna use the fillet command. Okay, I have selected this face. Now here I'll put 2 millimeters and press OK. Now we're gonna use fillet end for this edge and for this other one. So fillet, select this edge and here put 5 millimeters. Okay, and now select fillet again, select these edges. And here put 20 millimeters. Or let's try with 10. No, it's not working. 5 then, no. Doesn't want to work there, so I'm just gonna leave it like this. It's still looking good. Okay, what we have to do now, select front plane, open a sketch. Okay, and here draw a center line. Just like this. Then make a circle. Select the edge of the circle and this edge and make them tangent. Now just draw these lines. This here. And this other one. Okay, now let's mirror these two lines on this other side. Merge these points, select both of them with control pressed, and then press this merge points. Now let's define this sketch. Here we'll put 11.85, and from this point to this point 11.85. Okay, and from this point to this line should be 11.85, and between these two lines is 17, here is 20 millimeters, this line is 50 millimeters, and the sketch is fully defined. Now let's use trim entities and cut this circle, and then with circular sketch pattern we'll select the whole sketch and multiply it 5 times. Press OK, and now go to features, extruded cut, here will be 15, and direction 2 will be 6, it's OK, and press OK. And here we have our cut. Okay, what we have to do next is to cut this because it's too big. So select this face, open a sketch, normal 2, with convert entities we'll convert all of this, press OK, then go to features, extruded cut, and here leave 15 millimeters, press OK, and that's it. Now go here again, select this face, sketch, normal 2, and here I will draw a circle which will be 19 millimeters, and select the circle and this edge and make it concentric. Now multiply it with circular sketch, make 5 of them, press OK. Now go to features, extruded cut, here select through all, or you can select up to surface and then select this surface and press OK. Okay, now we're gonna use fillet. Now first we're gonna cut the extra material from inside. For this we have to open another sketch in the right plane, normal 2, go to display style, select to see the hidden lines, and then make the sketch as I am doing it. Select spline, and from here and come with this spline until you reach the middle of your wheel, and then you can model this. First, if you have here this coincidence, you'll have to delete it so you can move the point. So you can make it any shape you want, but I just like this. I like how this is looking. Now come with normal line from here and here to the middle and to this point. And then go to features, revolve and cut, select this line and press OK. Now select again, select this back, and the extra material is gone. Okay, what we have to do now is to use fillet command to make all these corners and edges round. So select fillet and select all of this. Okay, after you did this, just put here 31 mm and then press OK. Now what we have to do is to do the same with these corners. Select fillet, but this time put here 20 mm. And select all of them. Okay, then press OK. And it's almost done. What we have to do now is to make it from aluminium. So go to appearance, from appearance go to metal, and from metal go to aluminium. From aluminium you can select whatever you want. I'm gonna select this, drag it to the to your wheel, and select here body. Actually, I don't like this. from here, make it, you can choose the background. I'm gonna choose rooftop, I think. Yeah, it's looking very nice. And now we have to make it to look more like this one. So we're gonna make black, or black where you can see that this is black, just like in this picture. Okay, so select this, right click, appearance, face. Okay, we selected this, then select all of these faces. Select here black. Okay, and this is the real limb made after that picture. I hope that you enjoy it, and leave a comment if you are making it. Subscribe if you want to see more of this. And let's see if it's looking alike. So this is the picture, and this is what I just made. What do you think? You can tell me in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.